Welcome back. Well, the left has pushed the Russian collusion narrative and talked about impeachment, but with neither working, the left, well, they have a new talking point.
Should Americans be concerned about the president's mental fitness that he appears to be speaking so lightly about threats regarding the nuclear button?
None of this normal, none of this acceptable, none of this, frankly, stable behavior.
But isn't it remarkable that we're talking about the president's mental state and asking honest questions about his mental state? You also have members in Congress meeting with psychiatrists to talk about the 25th Amendment.
But will all this talk about the president's mental health actually backfire on Democrats? Fox News contributor David Webb joins us right now to react. I mean, I think we just wind you up and let you go.
No, I mean, the last part, talking to psychiatrists about, first of all, no credible psychiatrist would ever issue something on a patient unless they've actually met with the patient. So it's ridiculous. This is about a narrative that the Democrats need. They failed on impeachment. It was a farce. It didn't fall under anything. There has to be a chargeable crime. They now need a narrative because they fear what's coming. They're watching all of these investigations, the resistance movement and everything, be both ineffective and unraveling. The unraveling of this whole mess around Fusion GPS, the Mueller investigation, fruit of the poison tree, the term that's a legal application of that. Was it the poison tree with the dossier? Who paid for it? Was it used, as James Comey admitted, that he gave it to his Columbia law professor friend and leaked it, which, by the way, is also a violation of law under federal code, because those documents and anything, whether he did it on his laptop or not, are still within presidential privilege, and they had, but not that permission wasn't given to him. That unravels. Andrew McCabe, Weissman, you've got Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, and the big one in this, and I want Americans to pay attention, the coming name in this, Bruce and Nellie Orr. Bruce Orr, who resigned from DOJ, and his wife, Nellie, who worked for Fusion GPS. Add to that that something was very smart. Devin Nunes didn't give up his subpoena power. There was that false ethics charge. He was cleared. That subpoena power mattered because then nobody, Republican, Democrat, or bureaucrat, could stop him from subpoena. Now we have the unredacted documents, and that's key. Not redacted, unredacted, which are due by the 11th of next week.
But this whole narrative that the president is unfit, how insulting is that to voters of President Trump or those who see him as the disruptive leader that they want? Well, if he's unfit, then you voted. I mean, it's this whole, the left has to say, you're crazy, he's crazy, not maybe there's a strategy here.
They're driving it to their base. The fact is that when you go to the rest of the country, the people that support President Trump are not going to buy that narrative. So who are they driving it to? They're driving it to an ever-dwindling base. And we've watched the Democrat Party essentially not be a national party anymore. And some Democrats are concerned, but they're not in charge. Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer, Keith Ellison, Tom Perez, the other
Antifa
leaders.
Keith Ellison?
Yes, Antifa Keith Ellison, who holds up the Antifa manual as a way to resist fascism. I mean, these guys, they have nothing else. By the way, where's the bill they've presented? Where's their policy or argument?
Quick prediction, we got to go, yes or no. Will this boost or hurt the president, all this talk about the emperor has no clothes?
It'll do nothing. It will do nothing to him because he's got a coordinated effort and a strong base that supports him and success from tax policy.